Namaste. Last lecture, I have been conducting the different types of disease. I am continuing again some of the disease. There is a disease called meningitis. Meningitis is normally comes to the small children. After delivery, if the baby is heavy, it is, the head part is the very heaviest part in our body. This has come from the womb of the mother. But sometimes, what happens, due to the heavy weight, the baby goes on rotating and consumes the dirty liquid water which is collected in the stomach, in the womb. So when it drinks that water, it goes to the spinal cord and goes to the head. So it has to be removed before reaching the head. Once it is reaching the head, it is very difficult to remove the liquid. Then the child gets a fever and is affected. That is called meningitis. Even such child, when he is alive, is saved. Dangerous, because he remains like a mad person, mad, insane. So, better that, it has been cured before that. It's called meningitis. It normally is liquid secreted in the head later on. It's called Moolai Mudugu Thandi Veekam. I told you, Mudugu Thandi means on spinal cord, and Moolai means brain. So this liquid goes to both the place from spinal cord. So Moolai Thandi Mudugu Veekam. Veekam means swollen. And now next one is blood pressure. Normally we find blood pressure. The beauty is that God has made us like that. When we talk about the blood sugar, we say 80 by 120. The fasting we should have not more than 80. And after the food, again we should not reach more than 120. So 80 by 120 we say. The reverse of this is blood pressure. 120 by 80 we say. Diastolic and systolic. So this is the average. See, when we talk about blood sugar, we say 80 by 120. When we talk about blood pressure, we say 120 by 80. Blood pressure means what? Ratta kodipu. Our blood gets boiled, Ratta kodipu. It flows very fast. Due to that, we get a headache and our brain also gets little bit disturbed. It's called Ratta kodipu. It's called brain blood pressure. So meningitis is called Moolai or Mudugu Thandu Veekam. Thandu means that is cord. And Ratta Kodipu means blood pressure. Anemia is another type of this thing where the hemoglobin in the blood is less. And actually the blood is eaten away. I mean the red blood corpuscles are less to fight the immunity system is not there. So then these people require a blood again. This is called anemia, ratta chogai. Chogai means sometimes we say, even the basma, vibhuti what we call. You eat simply like that, na? They will say don't eat that, it will drink your blood. Sogay, that's called sogay. It's called anemia. And sore is a pun. Anything injured now, that's called sore. A pun, we call it. Poo in pun. Cancer. Cancer, we say putrunoi. Poo itrunoi. Putru means, just like a hole in our body system, where you find a hole in our, affected. That's called putrunoi. Everywhere you find this affected. Puttrunoi. Cough. Cough is a irumal. When we cough, it's called irumal. Irumal. Anemia. The itta sogai. Ratta sogai. For sore, we say pun. And for cancer, we say puttrunoi. And for cough, chile. So for cough, it's called irumal. cow comes cold, for any cold, na, when we get during the winter season, we get a cold, the jala dosham, always water oozing from our nose, jala dosham, dosham, dosham is a idea. Then there is another one called ascites. You find the abdomen part is just like Lord Ganapati, it is swollen because due to some water secreted in the stomach. It's called ascites. It's called neer kovai. Means some liquid is secreted in the stomach, the bottom part abdomen. Neer kovai. Neer kovai. Then there is an eye. After some time you get cataract. One of the layer formed in our iris and closes our vision. So that is called cataract. It's called kan purai. Kan purai means a screen like thing appear and closes our eyes vision. It has been removed. That part that growth is to be kan purai. Called cataract in English. The tumor. Sometimes some people get a tumor due to various reasons. It's called katti. It has been operated, removed. Either there are different types of tumor. You may not find the mouth from outside, it may be from inside. Abscess, what do you call abscess? So, it's different types of tumor which is secreted and it is secreted liquid as well as it become poisonous, burst out. Either in the stomach or whichever place. Even a brain tumor is also there. Due to the bad liquid or some infection, it grows. And it will be completely affect all the other parts. And sometimes even you get what do you call that? Chalam. It's like tumor, it's a brain tumor. I told you moolai means brain. Moolai katti. This is a very dangerous one. You know, the both sides of our forehead, we find a nerve. Always, you see, there is a liquid in our body, 3/4 our body is liquid. In brain also, there is a liquid. This fluid in the nerve, it is swollen sometimes. If they get a tumor, no? Tumor and get a severe headache. So, this has to be operated sometimes. Due to this, this operation is very dangerous. Sometimes they get affected. Either they lose the eyesight or they become dumb, deaf, everything. So ENT, all the things are connected. It's a very dangerous operation. Mostly neurologist only can do this. It's a very type. And India, especially Bombay, there was a Parsi doctor called Dastu, who was a lot of was expert in this brain tumor. He is no more now, but he was expert in the brain tumor. And moolai katti. Then boil. Boil means, you know, it's a koppalam. Anything is, you know, due to our fire injury or anything, it gets a boil. That's a koppalam. Ko ippulam koppalam. Then scabies. Scabies is another skin disease. Due to unhygienic conditions, our skin get affected. So we get itching or scratch. We scratch, you know, or itching. It's called chori chirang. Chori chirang. It is a skin disease called scabies. Now pain. Pain means, you know, any pain. It's called vali. Oh, mobile kira. Tala vali we say. Headache. Heart vali we say. Hridaya pain. And vaitha vali we say stomach pain. Like that, vali means pain. Vali, vali. So, brain tumor we say moolai katti. For boil we say koppalam. For scabies, a skin disease called chori and chirang. Chori and chirang. And pain we say vali. Scar means vadu. Any operations, anything done, sometimes you are injured. If we do the stitching or all, that will be a scar left out. Even people who have got smallpox, there will be a scar sometimes. After operation, there will be a scar, it cannot be removed.
Yeah. It's called vadu, vadu we say, vadu. A romanticism is called a vadam.
Kabam pittam vadam, no? We say a vadam.
It's a romanticism. Rheumatism is another vadam. It's a gas problem. Then epilepsy is another disease.
There is a weakness in the brain, nerve. So due to that, the epilepsy, suddenly these people are affected and they get tilted and no, they fall down, fits, they come and they fits. And sometimes no, the fluid from the saliva flows out.
It's called kakavarik.
Because just like you know, you would have seen, when you observed a crow bird, it sometimes behave like a kakavarik.
Just like this epilepsy.
That movement, no, it doesn't like that. So that's why it's called kakavarik.
And headache, I told you, talaivari. So I'm repeating, scar means vadu, epilepsy is kaka varippa ni ippu, and vadam means rheumatism, vada in vadam, and talaivari is headache.
Now suddenly, you know, we go in a hurry-burry, suddenly we get a sprain in our body.
The sprain is called chuduk.
Chamak in Hindi.
Chu-lu-ik chuduk. Anybody can get it. In Haribari we run or you know, jump sometimes.
Even though we are seen in the cricket match. Sometimes you know, they throw the ball while sleeping and getting up, sometimes they get this sprain.
And another thing is called whooping cough.
Whooping cough means you know, the cough, you know, it's a very tremendous cough. From the bottom of the abdomen, they go on coughing. That's a very with severe pain and this thing. It's called whooping cough.
That's called kakkuvan in Tamil.
Kakkuvan. As if they're going to vomit. With a very severe pain, they cough.
That's called kakkuvan. Kakkuvan in kakkuvan.
Then others, normally children get affected.
Dehydration.
Dehydration means, you know, in your body, the water in our body, it dried away. It's no water. Normally you see in the Somalia, Africa and all, the lot of children, they don't get a proper food. Due to that we find they are pale and you know, thin and all. So they are affected by dehydration.
So this is called neerpok.
It's our body.
Neerpok. Neerpok.
Means the water is not at all there. You have to feed the water and get it easy.
Another one is called the migraine.
Is you know, it's one side headache, a pain on the one side. Otta talavali is otta talavali. Either left side or right side, one part only that nerve you will get a severe pain. It's called otta talavali.
It's called migraine.
There's a two nerve which is migraine.
So it's called otta talavali. O itra. I am repeating once again, for sprain we say chuduk, for dehydration is called neerpok, and for whooping cough it's called kakkuvan, and for migration is otta talavali, talaivali. And this one is a night blindness, which is a very rare disease. Some people would not have seen this disease, but I have witnessed in Bombay also.
This is more or less found in Russia. It is found out in Russia.
It's night blindness.
People after evening they will not be able to see. It's called night blindness.
It's a Malaykan vyadi. We say Malay means evening. Can
after evening they will not be able to see.
It's called Malaykan.
For this, the doctors, there are doctors in Russia who operate this. You normally find in Russia, other place only this. Of course, very rarely you see the disease called night blindness.
And myopia. Myopia means, you know, kitta parvai.
You don't get a proper this thing to see letters from the near. From near you will be not able to see properly. any letters. That's called Kitta Parvai. Parvai means sight. Kitta means nearby.
So it's called Kitta Parvai. It's a myopia in English. That's good. Ki itta parvai. Kitta Parvai. This is Malai Kan. And obesity.
You find some people, you know, very bulky and swollen, you know, very fat. They don't have a real strength. Actually, a bone should have a good strength. So that's called Gundu Degam. Degam means Shariram. So Gundu Degam means obesity. That obesity has been removed, you know, due to fat or cholesterol.
And osteoporosis.
This is another type of disease. The weakness of a bone. You know, it gets affected. They affect the bone. And bone is not having a proper calcium. The bone gets brittle, you go on breaking. So normally it comes in the knee. This is called Irimbu Purai. Anybody gets osteoporosis, even their bone get bent, you know, and they fall down or it becomes powder, like, you know. So that's called a very dangerous one, osteoporosis.
So I'm repeating, light blindness, it's called Malai Kan. And for myopia, it's called Kitta Parvai. Obesity is called Gundu Degam. Osteoporosis, we say Elumbu Purai.
Yes.
Obesity